Hey everybody, in this video we are going to be looking at the setups we use when surf fishing for the sharks. We use 10 rods and 7 reels, and I mix and match them depending on the conditions. I'm going to break the video down into 3 sections: our main setups, our light setups, and our specialty setups. These are our main shark setups. They will throw 6 to 8 ounce sinkers and medium to large baits. A medium bait would be a whiting head, and a large bait would be a bluefish head. Each rod has been modified by cutting the butt shorter and putting a big Fuji butt cap on it. I also recorked them and put X-Flock grip over the new cork. With the leader system I use, the mono section is permanently attached to each reel, and that allows me to switch the reels to whatever rod I plan on using on the day that we're going to be going. The first setup we're going to look at is our 10-foot Ocean Master with 7 inches cut off the butt, and our Daiwa BG8000 with the 65-pound Suffix 832. This is the most versatile outfit we got and is the one that's used the most. The next outfit is our 11-foot Tika that has also 7 inches cut off the butt. It has our second BG8000, and that has 60-pound Seaguar Threadlock hollow core braid on it. The next outfit is our 12-foot Ocean Master with 9 inches cut off the butt and has the Cabo 120 that has 100-pound Jerry Brown hollow core braid on it. And the last outfit is our second 12-foot Ocean Master that has 5 inches cut off the butt, and it has our Fenor Offshore 7500 on it that has 65-pound Power Pro braid. The next outfits we're going to look at is our light shark outfits. Okay, these are our light shark setups. We also use them when we're fishing for the bluefish, when we throw the little pieces of cut whiting. They can all throw 4 or 5 ounce sinkers. And the first outfit is what I always call our light shark rod, and that's the Tsunami Airwave Elite 9'3" with the Fenor 5500 on it and 65-pound Jerry Brown solid braid. And we've caught a lot of nice sharks on that outfit, she including a 6'3" spinner shark. Okay, the next rod is our 8-foot Shimano Terramar extra heavy tarpon rod. It's got the Cabo 80, which has 50-pound Seaguar Threadlock hollow core braid on it. And that's the one I fought about a 6-foot tarpon with for 45 minutes before the hook pulled right at the end. The next rod is primarily what we use for the bluefish, but we did catch 5.5-foot blacktip on it. And that's our 9-foot Tika and our BG5000 that has 50-pound Suffix 832 braid on it. And the last rod, which doesn't have a reel on it, is our 9-foot Ocean Master that's had 4 inches cut off the butt. So we use these 4 rods and reel setups when we're fishing for the bluefish, or we think we're going to be looking for the blacknose sharks. The next outfits we're going to look at is our specialty rods. These are our specialty rods. They're 8.5-foot Tsunami Airwave Elite popping rods. They are made to throw big plugs to 150-pound tuna, but we use them for the shark fishing. I call them specialty rods because the conditions have to be just right at the beach for these rods to be used effectively. Mainly in the summertime when the surf is lighter and you're fishing right around high tide, or when it's low tide and I'm wading out 100 yards, where the rods are shorter, they're much easier to handle and cast. And if you hook a bigger shark, they just have tremendous amount of leverage and gives you a big advantage over a longer rod. We have 2 versions of the rod. The first rod is a heavy action 40 to 80 pound, and it's rated 2 to 4 ounce. That's a joke. The rod will throw a 6 ounce sinker and a medium sized shark bait. This is the exact setup with that BG8000 and the 60-pound hollow core braid that we caught the big tarpon on. The next outfit is the extra heavy 50 to 100-pound version that's rated 3 to 6 ounce, which is also a joke because I can throw an 8 ounce sinker and a decent sized shark bait with this. I bought the rod and the Cobble 120 and the 100 pound braid as a kayak rod for when we fish with my nephew, which we haven't had a chance to do. She did catch a 65 inch black tip on the rod before I started the channel, which is why I bought her the heavy action rod. So I hope this helps some people out if you're looking at some unconventional rods for fishing for the sharks.
Thanks for watching.